Dear learners, today we will discuss a chapter on motion in a plane. In that, we will discuss first the projectile motion. In the preceding two lessons, we have studied the concepts related to motion in a straight line. Can you describe the motion of objects moving in a plane, that is, in two dimensions, using the concepts discussed so far? To do so, we have to introduce certain new concepts. An interesting example of motion in two dimensions is the motion of a ball thrown at an angle to the horizontal. This motion is called a projectile motion. Now, why do we study projectile motion? What should be the position and speed of an aircraft so that food or medicine packets dropped from it reach the people affected by floods or an earthquake? Or how should an athlete throw a discus or a javelin so that it covers a maximum horizontal distance? In such cases, we need the concepts of projectile motion. Now, the objectives of this lesson are to explain projectile motion and give their examples, to derive expressions for the time of flight, range and maximum height of a projectile, to derive the equations of the trajectory of a projectile. The first breakthrough in the description of projectile motion was given by Galileo. He showed that the horizontal and vertical motion of a slow moving projectile are mutually independent. To understand this, let us do an activity. Take two balls. One ball is dropped vertically downward direction and another ball is thrown in the horizontal direction. Then you can see that both the balls hit the ground at the same time. So the downward acceleration of a projectile is the same as that of a freely falling body. You are throwing one ball horizontally and another ball is dropped vertically downward. So both the balls have the same downward acceleration. Another thing is that the vertical motion takes place independent of its horizontal motion. Previously we told that both the balls have same downward acceleration. That means in the second case, when we are throwing a ball in the horizontal direction, it is covering some horizontal distance also. But the vertical motion takes place independent of its horizontal motion. Another thing you can observe is that the horizontal velocity continues unchanged and independent of the vertical motion in the second case where we are throwing the ball horizontally. From this, we can find out some properties of projectile motion. What are they? The two important properties of projectile motion are a constant horizontal velocity component and a constant vertically downward acceleration component. And these two combinations of motion results in the curved path of projectile. You can see in the figure that the path of the projectile is a curved one. Now, what are the components of projectile motion? As we have studied in the second law of Newton, that when no force is applied, then there will be no acceleration in the object. In case of projectile motion, there are two components, vertical component and horizontal component. In case of horizontal component, what happens? No force is applied in the horizontal direction. That means no acceleration is there in the object, hence the velocity will be constant. And the vertical component of the projectile motion has one force component, that is the gravitational force. Hence, as force is applied, there will be acceleration, and that acceleration will be equal to the acceleration due to gravity. Hence, A equal to g. And here, the velocity component will change and it is an accelerated motion. Suppose a boy at A throws a ball with an initial horizontal speed. According to Newton's second law, there will be no acceleration in the horizontal direction unless a horizontally directed force acts on the ball. Ignoring friction of air, the only force acting on the ball once it is free from the hand of the boy is the force of gravity. So now, as the ball is moving under the force of gravity and the gravitational force is in the downward direction, hence the vertical component of projectile will have force and the horizontal component of velocity will be constant. What are the two velocities of a projectile? The horizontal speed and the vertical speed. The horizontal speed is denoted by VH and it remains constant. It does not change because there is no component of force in horizontal direction. And the vertical speed, that is denoted by VV, is uniformly accelerated, as in vertical direction there is force of gravity and there is an acceleration, that is acceleration due to gravity. Hence, the vertical component of velocity is accelerated one. So, the final velocity of the projectile V equal to root over of VH square plus VV square. And what will be the direction of the velocity, the final velocity? It is tangential to the trajectory. You can see in the figure the horizontal component VH and the vertical component VV, and the direction of final velocity V is tangential to the trajectory. Having defined the projectile motion, we would like to determine how high and how far does the projectile go and for how long does it remain in air. These factors are important if we want to launch a projectile to land at a certain target. For example, a football in the goal, a cricket ball beyond the boundary, relief packets in the reach of people marooned by floods or other natural disasters. Let us analyze projectile motion to determine its maximum height, time of flight and range. In doing so, we will ignore effects such as wind or air resistance. We can characterize the initial velocity of an object in projectile motion by its vertical and horizontal components. Let us take the positive x-axis in the horizontal direction and the positive y-axis in the vertical direction. Let us assume that the initial position of the projectile is at the origin O at t equal to 0, that is time equal to 0 when you are starting the observation. As you know, the coordinates of the origin are x equal to 0 and y equal to 0. Now, suppose the projectile is launched with an initial velocity V0 at an angle theta 0, which is known as the angle of elevation. Let us know what are the symbols used. V0 is the initial velocity. Theta 0 is the angle of elevation to the x-axis. VOX equal to the component of initial velocity along x-axis. VOY is the component of initial velocity along y-axis. AX is the horizontal component of acceleration and AY is the vertical component of acceleration. Now, what are the component of velocity and acceleration along x-axis and y-axis? The components in the x and y directions are VOX, that is component of velocity along x-axis, this is V0 cos theta 0. VOY equal to V0 sin theta 0. Here we have taken the component of velocity along x and y axis. AY, that is acceleration along y axis, which is equal to minus g, that is equal to minus of 9.8 meter per second square. Here this negative sign before g indicates that the acceleration due to gravity is always in the negative y direction, because the positive direction or positive y direction is in the upward direction and g, that is acceleration due to gravity, is always in downward direction, hence the negative sign is given here. Ay is constant, that means acceleration due to gravity is constant. In case of projectile motion, it contains two motions, that is one vertical component and one horizontal component of a single object, and both the motion takes place simultaneously. The horizontal motion Vx equal to Vox, that is the horizontal component of velocity is constant because the component of acceleration along x axis is zero, hence the velocity is constant. That means the distance covered in horizontal direction will be x equal to velocity into time, that is Vox into t, which is equal to Vox is V0 cos theta 0 and time t. So, x equal to V0 cos theta 0 t. Vy, that is the vertical component of velocity, is equal to Voy minus Gt. Here we have used the equation V equal to u plus At, because in case of vertical motion there is acceleration, hence we have taken this equation. So, the final velocity is Vy, initial velocity is Voy, acceleration is taken as minus g, hence Vy equal to Voy minus Gt, that is equal to Voy equal to V0 sin theta 0, and equation becomes Vy equal to V0 sin theta 0 minus Gt. Similarly, we can find out the distance covered in the vertical direction, that is y equal to Voyt minus half Gt square. Here we have used the equation of motion, that is s equal to ut plus half At square. Here the initial velocity is Voy, that is why we have written y equal to Voyt minus half Gt square. Minus sign is due to A equal to minus g. So, that is equal to V0 sin theta 0 t minus half Gt square. The horizontal motion is the motion with constant velocity, and the vertical motion is motion with constant downward acceleration. The vector sum of the two respective components would give us the velocity and position of the projectile at any instant of time. Now, let us make use of these equations to know the maximum height, time of flight and range of the projectile. Here there are some points to remember. When we are considering projectile motion, we have ignored or we have assumed certain things. We have assumed that there is no air resistance, because there is always air resistance, and due to air resistance there is some variations in the motion of the projectile. But that will be very tricky, or that will be very complex for our calculation purpose. Therefore, we have assumed that there is no air resistance. We have also assumed that effect due to rotation of earth is negligible, and the acceleration due to gravity is constant in magnitude and direction at all points of the motion of projectile. Now, let us calculate maximum height. First of all, what is maximum height? At the instant when the projectile is at the maximum height, the vertical component of its velocity is zero. Alternatively, we can say that when the vertical component of the velocity of projectile is zero, that is the maximum height covered. We have seen that the velocity of a projectile along vertical direction goes on decreasing when it is moving upward due to the acceleration due to gravity, and at a certain point it becomes zero. Up to that point only the projectile moves in upward direction. After that it gradually comes downward. So, that is the maximum height covered. Now, let us calculate the maximum height. Now, applying the equation of motion v square minus u square equal to 2as, here the distance covered is the height covered, That's why we will use s equal to h, that is the maximum height. Here a equal to g, acceleration due to gravity. So now the equation becomes minus g y equal to half v y square minus v over square. Here the final velocity v equal to v y, initial velocity u equal to v over, and acceleration is minus g. Now as y equal to h, v y equal to 0, that is the final velocity is 0 at the highest point, and v over, that is the initial velocity, equal to v 0 sin theta 0. So the equation becomes s equal to v 0 square sin square theta 0 divided by 2g. Now what is time of flight? The time of flight of a projectile is the time interval between the instant of its launch and the instant when it hits the ground. Alternatively, we can say time of flight is total time for which the projectile is in the air. So now putting Vy equal to 0, 0 equal to V over minus Gt. Here we have used the equation V equal to U plus At, A equal to minus G, V equal to 0, and U equal to V over. So time taken to rise to the maximum height is T equal to V over divided by G. That is equal to V 0 sin theta 0, as V over equal to V 0 sin theta 0 divided by G. So what is the time of flight? This is the time required to rise to the maximum height, but the total time of flight is equal to the time of ascent plus time of descent, that is equal to 2t. The total time of flight t, capital T, is equal to twice of small t, that is equal to 2 times v 0 sin theta 0 divided by g. Now what is range? The distance travelled horizontally by the projectile is called range. So r, that is range, equal to vox into 2t. Vox is the horizontal velocity component and 2t is the total time of flight. That is equal to vox is v0 cos theta 0 and t equal to v0 sin theta 0 divided by g. So the equation becomes v0 cos theta 0 into 2v0 sin theta 0 divided by g. Finally, we get r equal to v0 square 2 sin theta 0 cos theta 0 divided by g. But as you know, 2 sin theta 0 cos theta 0 equal to sin 2 theta 0. So we get r equal to v0 square sin 2 theta 0 divided by g. Here you can see that the range of a projectile depends upon its initial velocity v0 and its direction, that is given by theta 0. So these are the two components or two factors upon which the range of a projectile depends. Now you can determine the angle at which a disc or a hammer or a javelin should be thrown so that it covers maximum distance horizontally. Alternatively, we can find out the angle for which the range will be maximum. So how to find out angle for maximum range? As we have seen, r equal to, that is range equal to v0 square sin 2 theta 0 divided by g. For any given speed, the v0 will be constant and r will be maximum when sin 2 theta 0 will be maximum. So sin 2 theta 0 will be maximum when its value is 1. So sin 2 theta 0 equal to 1, that means 2 theta 0 equal to 90 degree, that means theta 0 equal to 45 degree. So now putting theta 0 equal to 45 degree, we found out maximum range rm equal to v0 square divided by g. Now we have found out the total time of flight, the maximum height covered, and the expression for range. So now let us do a numerical. Suppose a football player kicks a ball at an angle of 30 degree with an initial speed of 20 meter per second. Assuming that the ball travels in a vertical plane, calculate the time at which the ball reaches the highest point, the maximum height reached, the horizontal range of the ball, the time for which the ball is in the air. Take the value of g equal to 10 meter per second square. So now let us find the solution. As we know the time required to reach the maximum height t equal to the total time of flight divided by 2, that is capital T by 2, which is equal to v0 sin theta divided by g, and v0 equal to 20 meter per second. It is given g equal to 10 meter per second square. So the equation becomes t equal to 20 divided by 10 into sin 30 degree. Theta is given 30 degree, that is equal to 1 second. So the time required to reach the maximum height is 1 second. What is the maximum height? Maximum height equal to v0 square sin square theta divided by 2g, that is equal to, if you put all the value given, then it becomes 5 meter. So the maximum height covered is 5 meter. Now you can also calculate range by putting all the values given in the formula for range, that is v0 square sin 2 theta divided by g, which is equal to 34.64 meter, and the total time of flight is equal to twice of small t. That is, also you can use the formula for time of flight, that is 2 v0 sin theta divided by g, and put all the values and it comes out to be 2 seconds. So this is how you can use the formulas for total time of flight, range and maximum height and find out the solution for numericals. Now let us discuss trajectory of a projectile. What is trajectory? Trajectory is the path followed by a projectile. You can see the two figures given here. Here both the figures are the path followed by a projectile. So can you now say what is the shape of the trajectory? To find out the shape of trajectory, we have to first determine the equation for the trajectory of a projectile. And for that, we have to eliminate t, the term t, from equation for x and y, that is the distance covered in horizontal direction and the distance covered in vertical direction. The distance covered in horizontal direction, x, is equal to Vox into t, that is equal to V0 cos theta 0 into t. Now simplifying this, we get x divided by V0 cos theta 0 equal to t. Putting this value of t in the equation for y, that is the distance covered in vertical direction, as we know y equal to V0 sin theta 0 t minus half gt square. So in place of t, we can put x divided by v0 cos theta 0. So it becomes y equal to v over y, that is v0 sin theta 0 is v over y. In place of t, we put x divided by vox as vox equal to v0 cos theta 0 minus half gx square divided by vox square. In place of t square, we have put x square divided by Vox square. Now y equal to 10 theta 0 x, because V0 sin theta 0 divided by V0 cos theta 0 equal to 10 theta 0. So 10 theta 0 into x minus g divided by 2 V0 cos theta 0 whole square into x square. So this is the equation of trajectory. Now you can see the equation of trajectory, that is y equal to 10 theta 0 x minus g divided by 2 v0 cos theta 0 square into x square. we can write this equation as y equal to ax plus bx square. Here a is the coefficient of x, that is 10 theta 0, and b is the coefficient of x square, that is g divided by 2 v 0 cos theta 0 whole square. Here a is the coefficient of x, that is 10 theta 0, and b is the coefficient of x square, that is minus g divided by 2 v 0 cos theta 0 square. And this equation y equal to ax plus bx square is an equation of parabola. So now we can say that the equation of trajectory is an equation of parabola. Hence, the shape of trajectory is parabolic. Hence, the path of any projectile launched at an angle to the horizontal is a parabola or a portion of parabola. Now, let us summarize what we have discussed today. Projectile motion is defined as the motion which has constant velocity in a certain direction and constant acceleration in a direction perpendicular to that of velocity. Ax equal to 0, Ay equal to minus g. Vx, that is horizontal component of velocity, equal to V0 cos theta 0. Vy, the vertical component of velocity, equal to V0 sin theta 0 minus gt. X, the distance covered in horizontal direction, equal to x0 plus v0 cos theta into t. Y equal to y0 plus v0 sin theta into t minus half gt square. The total time of flight t equal to 2 v0 sin theta divided by g. Range of the projectile r equal to v0 square sin 2 theta divided by g. The equation of trajectory of a projectile is y equal to 10 theta 0 x minus g divided by 2 v 0 cos theta 0 square into x square, and the shape of trajectory is a parabola. I hope you have understood what we have discussed today. Wishing you all the best. Thank you.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े बे विषय के लोग।